Do you know that a few minutes of mental silence every day makes your brain younger? It improves your mental and your physical health. It improves your attention and it improves the control of your emotions. My name is Sergio Elias Hernandez Alonso. I have been practicing meditation for the last 33 years and I've been doing research about meditation and neuroscience for the last 11 years. Let me share with you what I have discovered during all these years. We humans has a full language for the last 40 or 50,000 years. The language is very, very quite important for our life, for our evolutions, for our societies. But our language has one side effect. And this side effect is that the language is reproduced on our mind as thoughts without a stop. We are thinking, 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 and we do not stop the thinking process. And it's quite, quite difficult to stop our thinking. This too much thinking takes us to the future, takes us to the past. And sometimes when it goes beyond, much beyond our control, we can enter into depression, anxiety, or stress. So let me show you what science has shown about this. Well, this article that I share with you was published on this journal Science in 2010 with the title "A Wandering Mind is an Unhappy Mind." This research was made with around 5,000 volunteers from 83 different countries. It was very simple and very clever at the same time. So they were sending messages to the telephones of the volunteers, asking them, how are you? Where is your attention? What are you doing? What they discovered was that those volunteers with their attention in the here and now, they are those who were happier, as it is shown on this figure here, not my wondering. The conclusion that is on the last paragraph that is here, let me read. In conclusion, a human mind is a wandering mind, and a wandering mind is an unhappy mind. The ability to think about what is not happening is a cognitive achievement that comes at an emotional cost. So, the question is, how do we stop our thinking processes? How can we be in silence, in mental silence? Well, in the ancient yoga, they say that the yoga means union, is achieved when we stop our thinking processes. They call it nirvichara. In 1970, Srimati Nirmala Devi founded a type of yoga that she gave the name Sahaya Yoga. Sahaya means born with you, and yoga, as I already said, means union. With this yoga, you have the capacity to feel all the centers, channels, and everything, especially on your fingertips, on your hands, and you can reach easily this state of mental silence. Let me show you some examples of research with the benefits of this mental silence. This research was published in 2012 on this journal, Evidence-Based Complementary Alternative Medicine. And they compare the mental health of the Australian population with the practitioners of the Sahaya yoga meditation with mental silence. They saw that there was a correlation between the frequency of achievement of mental silence and mental health. So those who were practicing the meditation and reaching this mental silence several times a day on this column had the best mental health. In blue, those reaching just one or twice per day, very good mental health. Even those in orange with one or twice mental silence state per week had better mental health than the Australian population. But there was a small group, around 4% of meditators, who didn't reach much this mental silence state. They reach here one or twice a month, or less than once a month. And they had a mental health that was scored lower than the average. So the conclusion is clear. If you want to have the benefits of the benefits of this meditation, you should reach this state of mental silence. And also, as proposed by the founder Srimati Nirmala Devi, the real state of meditation is achieved when you reach this state of mental silence. This mental silence through Sahaja Yoga meditation has benefits for many several severe conditions like stress, depression, anxiety, attention deficit hyperactive disorder, asthma, cardiac arrhythmias, diabetes, high blood pressure, menopause, epilepsy, and others. Here is the year and the first author of each of these scientific documents. So let's move to the research we have been doing in my university, is the University of La Laguna, Tenerife, Spain. All our research has been done on this magnetoresonance scanner, and here is the brain of the control room of the last volunteer. We have done three types of research. First, we were looking at the activity in our brain during this mental silence. The second was related with the comparison of the anatomy between meditators and non-meditators. And the third one was functional connectivity, watching how the different parts of the brain cooperate when you are in mental silence. So on the first research, we asked volunteers to try to be in mental silence inside the magnetoresonance scanner. And they did three short consecutive meditation, 2 minutes each. On the first meditation, they had a large amount of activity here in yellow, depicted in yellow, mainly on frontal and temporal lobes, that is your effort to silence your mind. On the second was much less activity, it was a kind of transition to the third meditation, in which most of meditators said that they reached this state of mental silence. On the third meditation, the main activity was on this area that is called the insula at the right hemisphere. And this insula is related with the what is called the interoception. Interoception is your capacity to feel how you are, to have somehow a feedback, because our body informs us how we are. But if we are all the time here on our mind thinking, we lose the control, we lose the perception of our body, of our viscerals, and we are there, just in the past or just in the future. So this attention in the here and now is very much related with this insular activity. This study was published on the Journal of Alternative and Complementary Medicine, 2015. And one important point was this integration of body and mind. As I already said, the main subject of our research during these years was the comparison of anatomy of meditators practicing Sahaja Yoga meditation, reaching mental silence, and non-meditators. In order to understand, to better understand this type of research, we should know that our brain has three different types of tissues, depending on the color. We have gray matter, that is mainly here on the periphery. We have white matter, that is the long connections. And we have the cerebrospinal fluid, that is the liquid that incises the holes in some part of our brain. The gray matter is quite important because it represents the nucleus of the neurons and the connection between neurons. And there is one of the main topics of neuroscience today is what is called neuroplasticity. Neuroplasticity is the capacity of our brain to change and to adapt itself to every new situation. And the neuroplasticity means that our brain is doing new connections every moment. Your brain today is a little bit different from your brain tomorrow. And these new connections create more or less gray matter. Let me show you an example. This study published in 2004 was about the students learning to juggle, to keep balls in the air. First, they didn't have any previous experience with juggling, and they went inside the magnetoresonance scanner. Afterwards, they were practicing every day, around an hour, and they went for the second time inside the scanner. On those areas depicted here in yellow, got larger gray matter volume. After the second time at the scanner, they stopped practicing, and those same areas in yellow got less gray matter. This allows us to understand that the gray matter behaves a little bit like muscles, little muscles that the more we use them, the more they expand because they create new connections, and the less we use them, they have less gray matter. So it's also important to note that when we get older, we have less gray matter, and also there are a correlation of a losing of gray matter with very important diseases like Parkinson, schizophrenia, or even Alzheimer. If you compare a healthy brain with a brain with Alzheimer, mild or severe Alzheimer disease, the difference is quite big. So in our research, we have 23 meditators practicing this Sahaja Yoga meditation for more than 5 years, and we compare them with an equivalent group of 23 non-meditators, equivalent on age, same amount of men and women, and also they were equivalent in the level of education. What we saw is that the main result was that meditators have larger, 7% larger gray matter volume in the whole brain. And this difference is quite important because in very important sickness, for example, schizophrenia, that is one of the most severe mental problems, you have a loss in the whole brain around 2-3%. So this 7% is a very, very big difference. It's the biggest difference ever published in a scientific journal. So here on this graphic, we can every red dot is a meditator, and every blue dot is a control. Meditators, not only they have larger gray matter, but also the tendency as a group diminishes slower than the control group here in blue. You see, when we are 20, both groups have similar, around 47, almost half of the brain is gray matter. But when we are around 65, if you are in the meditators group, you are probably are on this area, around 43-44%, but if you are not, you are in the 41. And to keep your gray matter intact is very important for your mental health. This study was published in this journal, PLOS ONE, in 2016, and it was one of the most read and downloaded. And just a few days ago, July 29th, 2021, the journal sent us an email saying that our article was among the top 10% most cited that year. We did a review of our data, and we published a new article just last year, 2020, on the same journal, PLOS ONE. And we did a comparison area by area in the whole brain between those meditators and those controls. And we saw that in all areas, meditators had larger gray matter volume. But this larger gray matter volume was statistically significant in many important areas or lobes, like here, the frontal lobes and the right temporal lobes. Frontal lobes are very important because they allow us to take decisions, and they define very much our personality. They define very much who we are. And as I already said, this difference is the largest gray matter difference published in a scientific or scientific journal. So the last type of research we have been doing during these years is about functional connectivity, how the different parts of the brain cooperate. On this research, first we saw that there was a very specific area, it's called anterior cingulate, in which meditators had larger gray matter volume. And this larger gray matter volume was associated with the capacity of meditators to be in mental silence. So those meditators with the better capacity to reach mental silence have larger gray matter volume there. This area is very important because it has been mentioned in other research by other researchers. That is related with the probability to be a happier person because of your control of your attention and the control of your emotions. And also the opposite is, has been mentioned by other groups, like lower gray matter volume there is related with depression and anxiety. So what we saw is that meditation had larger gray matter volume here, and also this area was cooperating with those areas here in red. That's again the insula, the interoception, and also the putamen, the state of joy, to enjoy your moment, your meditation. And also there was a disconnection with this area here in blue. So this is the last research. This was published in 2018 in the journal called Neuroscience. And just to conclude, let me repeat that mental silence implies having your attention in here and now, that is correlated with an integration of your body and your mind. It is also very important to achieve frequency this mental silence because it's related or correlated with your mental health. It makes your brain younger and improves your attention and the control of your emotion. And these two define very much how you are, how happy you are. And just to finish, mental silence allow us to get rid of our wandering mind. Because as I already said, a wandering mind is an unhappy mind. And a mental silence mind is a happier mind. So I take this opportunity to invite you to practice this Hatha Yoga meditation because it is free all over the world. It's very simple. There is no condition. And I encourage you to practice, but not give it just some time. Be a little bit patient. And you, in a few weeks, let's say in 1-2 months, you can see a tremendous change and improvement on your life. So thank you very much for your precious attention. Bye.